Very good morning to you everyone. Let us will have the topic in our last class where we have left. In order to have a continuation of that, we will be going to have about that peritoneum topic which we had started long back. I mean to say day earlier. That is peritoneum. We had finished parietal part of the peritoneum, the one which will be representing in this diagram, that is a red in color. This is what is said to be the female pelvic cavity. And by the way, you will be having a one more, you can say, pelvic cavity. That will be the what is said to be as a male pelvic cavity. So in which male pelvic viscera are there, namely urinary bladder, prostate, ductus deferens, this, then the ureter, this ductus deferens is resting here, then this is the seminal vesicle, rectum. But in case of female, urinary bladder is there, ureter is there, uterus will be there, this uterus ending into the water, cervix opens into the vagina, that vagina will be there like this, these are the vaginal conuses, then you will be having rectum, the boundary of the what pelvic cavity in both, in front pubic symphysis, behind sacrum, below you will be having the pelvic diaphragm, pelvic diaphragm. So this is the PD, pelvic diaphragm. Here you have a PD in female and in the male, that will be the remaining boundary will be the same. And on either side, you will be having above superior ramus of the pubis, below laterally you will be having a inferior ramus of the pubis, then you will be having on either side ischial tuberosity, then the ramus of the ischium. Apart from that, there will be interrupted laterally on either side the obturator foramina and the internal aspect of that of the acetabular cavity. So like that, behind you have got a sacrum, in front of the pubic symphysis. So like that, this pelvic cavity is formed. Now you have to go to the what in case of male, above it will be there like this. So this will be the what, umbilicus. This is the pubic symphysis. So this will be the what, lower part of the abdomen. So this is what, parietal part of the peritoneum. So this is what in case of male. But you will be having like this. So these are the vertebrae. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 lumbar vertebrae. Then this will be the what, diaphragm. I will take this part out for our things because it should be not coming between. So it will be there like this. So this is the thing, and this will be the diaphragm. This is the diaphragm, respiratory diaphragm. And definitely this will be the what? Diaphragmatic fascia. Okay? So now we will have this visceral part of the peritoneum. Visceral part of the peritoneum, as the hypothesis goes, or the theory goes on the what visceral part, it is a continuation of the what, that of the parietal part of the peritoneum. Parietal part of the peritoneum. So I will be going to mark with the some orange color. Because there will be a difference. So this is called as a visceral part of the peritoneum. Visceral part of the peritoneum is the one which will be starting from the umbilicus. It may run internal aspect of that of the anterior abdominal wall or anterolateral abdominal wall and reaching to the organ, or from one organ to the another organ, or organ from the wall, under surface of the wall, to that of the diaphragm, where then you can say parietal part of the peritoneum covers, leaving the gap, leaving the bare area for liver. It may go there. Then from the water, under surface of the, you can say, diaphragm, to the water, any of the other organ, or from one organ to the water, another organ, or internal aspect of the posterior abdominal wall to the organ. So this thing is called as a visceral part of the peritoneum. The meaning of this is, this visceral part of the peritoneum is covering from the body cavity to, or from the boundary of the abdominal cavity to the organ, or from the organ to the organ, or from the anterior aspect of the posterior abdominal wall to the organ, not only in the abdomen proper, in male, because in male it remains in, then even in the water, that of the pelvic cavity. That is called as a visceral part. The meaning of visceral means organs. The layer which covers the organs. Rather it is called as a splenic part. Splenicology means it is the study of the organs. So in that connection. So now this visceral part of the peritoneum, what it contains? The visceral part of the peritoneum, it contains the flattened endothelial and the flattened mesothelial cells in its histological aspect. Apart from that, it contains a little amount of fibrous, more amount of the water areolar. So, as because it is connecting organ to the organ, or internal aspect of the body cavity, means abdominal cavity, to the organ, or from the internal aspect of the posterior abdominal wall to the organ, in abdomen proper, and as well as in the pelvic cavity, in male and in the female. So, if this is the thing for this, what must be the what embryology for this? Embryology for the visceral part of the peritoneum, it will be going to develop or derive from the splenic-pleural cavity, which is present in between the two lateral plate of the mesolar. As the development proceeds in the fetal life, in connection with the abdominal cavity, it will be going to get covered. The entire, you can say, organs, where it will be giving a protective mechanism or protective function for the organs. So that is a thing. Now, if that development is finished, now the question is how this, you can say, visceral part of the peritoneum can be studied. Visceral part of the peritoneum can be studied or can be described as a what? Two parts. One is called as cortical dispositions. Cortical dispositions. 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 And another one is horizontal dispositions. Horizontal dispositions. The meaning of this is, it is so simple. from the extension of this, you can say if that visceral part of the peritoneum is running vertically or rather longitudinally after covering the internal aspect of the aorta and anterior abdominal wall and anterolateral abdominal wall even, then towards the what organ or from the one organ to the another organ which are placed one above the another in the abdominal cavity or in the pelvic cavity, then from that thing to the what internal aspect of that of the cancer posterior abdominal wall or posterolateral abdominal wall, or from the internal aspect of the posterior abdominal wall to the what any of the organs which will be there just you can say below to that, that is called as vertical disposition. Vertical disposition. Now, what is the meaning of these transverse dispositions? Transverse dispositions are those which are also said to be as a horizontal disposition because they are running horizontally. So, these horizontal dispositions are almost all present in the what upper quadrant of the or upper supracolic compartment of the water, that of the you can say abdominal cavity or the upper abdominal cavity, where the organs are run, placing side by side to each other or one next to the another, very close in compact. So that is the thing. More than that, some you can say organs which are there in the water, that of the pelvic cavity, those will be also you can say they are front to back or back to front, they are placed. So there also you will be going to have the horizontal or the transverse disposition of the water, the peritoneum of the visceral part. Now this you can say when you will be studying this either the vertical or longitudinal and the water horizontal or the water transverse, you have to remember that that will be going to tell in the name or in the version of or in the fashion of folds, because these you can say vertical disposition when it is traveling either the vertical or the water horizontal pattern, it will be running to and fro. And then it will be, once again, at some point, it will be reflecting back, giving rise to the folds. So those folds are the what? Pattern of extensions of the what? Either the longitudinal or the what? Transverse disposition of the visceral part of the peritoneum. So we are using often and often folds. Even when that folds become continuously usage, we will be going to use as about sometimes the ligaments, sometimes the ligament. So what is a ligament ultimately? Ligament is nothing but it is a one of the one which will be connecting from one part to the another part or from one organ to the another organ in connection with the visceral part of the what, that of the peritoneum. So you should know about these things, two words. And as I have told already, there will be about one more term often used as a word of retro means behind. Retro means behind. And we will be using often and often some, you know, bags which are left, some which are sacs has been left between two organs, when that visceral part of the peritoneum will be extended. So those are called as a what? Pouch, sac, bag, or rather we'll be going to tell as a what? Fossa. So like that we'll be using. So these are the terms where we are using. Now let us we'll go to the word that of the you can say vertical disposition of the visceral layer of the peritoneum. So first to start with. So
So now, vertical disposition of the vertebral layer of the peritoneum is one of the ones which will be starting from the umbilicus and it will be going to run upwards for the covering of the internal aspect of anterior abdominal wall and as well as the anterolateral abdominal wall. But when it is touches to the lower border of the So liver is also called as a what? Hepat. Hepat means liver. So when it reaches to that particular disposition of the visceral layer of the peritoneum at the lower part of liver or the lower border of the liver, it would be going to split into two. One is a what? Inferior layer and another is a superior layer. So this is called as inferior layer now that inferior layer divides into two via the vertical disposition of the visceral layer of the peritoneum when it is starting from the umbilicus. Now this ligament is called as ligamentum teres of So this is what the inferior layer of the what ligamentum teres of a liver and this will be the what superior layer of ligamentum teres of liver. Ligamentum teres of liver. Now that when inferior layer of the ligamentum of teres of liver. Now, so this is what the liver. So this will be the what inferior layer, and this will be the what superior layer. From this, so here, this superior layer of the what that of the ligamentum teres of liver, when it will be running on the what anterior surface of the what that of the liver and then it will be going to run forwards and then it will be reaching to the geopodal fibers of the diaphragm. So this ligament is called as or fold of vertical disposition of the visceral layer is called as falciform ligament of liver. Now this falciform ligament of liver which will be running on the what anterior surface of right anterior surface of the liver, after running you can say little forwards and then more upwards to attach to the geopodal fibers of the diaphragm, it will be tends to divide the liver into the what right lobe and the what left lobe. Now after having a division made by this falciform ligament, it is tried to split once again into a what two. Now this is called as left layer of falciform ligament of liver. Now this is up till this short distance is called as the right layer of ligamentum teres of liver or falciform. Now this will be going to run further on the what superior surface of the right lobe of the liver, which will be going to set to be as superior layer of right coronary ligament.
So this may be said to be as left layer of ligamentum teres of lever or falciformum ligament of lever or left coronary ligament.
Coronary means these are the arms, corona.
Now this will be the what? The superior layer of the right coronary ligament. Now this superior layer of the right coronary ligament runs on the what? The superior surface of the right lobe of the lever, and then it is once again running downwards and a little backwards. Downwards and a little backwards.
Now in order to understand that triangular ligament, I have showed draw here now. So this will be the what? Your posterior surface of right lobe of a lever. So this will be the what? Right triangular ligament. The right triangular ligament, which is a continued part of a superior layer of the coronary ligament. Right. So superior right coronary ligament extends running on the superior part of the what? Right lobe of the lever, and then it will be running downwards and more backwards towards the medial, where it will be going to finish or completes the right triangular ligament, and then it gives the way for the formation of inferior layer of left coronary ligament. So this inferior layer of the water left coronary ligament, right coronary ligament, which will be going to run over the, or it will be cover over the vein. That vein is called as the inferior vena cava. So thereby inferior layer of the right coronary ligament, which is coming from the right triangular ligament, is going to cover over the inferior vena cava. So that is called as ligamentum venosum. Ligamentum venosum. So this will be the thing where it will be there. So this will be going to form, what is said to be as the boundary of upper, behind that of the, you can say, right limit of porta hepatis. Porta hepatis. So this is the inferior layer. Ligamentum venosum, which is coming from the end of the inferior layer of right coronary ligament, as because it is covering the inferior, and it forms the what? Upper behind right limit of porta hepatis. So this will be the thing here. Now let us will have, after this ligamentum venosum running, you can say, downwards with the covering, it will be going to encircle the entire diameter and the breadth of the porta hepatis. Porta hepatis is the what? It is the gateway for the lever inferior surface. So this will be the thing. Now by the way, when it will be running like this, there will be an inferior layer of the ligamentum teres of lever, which will be coming after covering the what? Inferior surface of the entire left lobe as well as right lobe. It comes here, and then it will be going to lodge in the what? That of the fossa of the inferior layer of that of the ligamentum teres of lever, which will be continuing upwards
remaining part of inferior surface of the left lobe of the levers, and this will be going to cover the inferior surface of the right lobe of the lever by ligamentum venosum. So this will be the thing. After forming that ligamentum venosum at this point, encircling completion, the ligamentum venosum further it will be going to run towards the right part of the vertebra, that of the inferior layer of ligamentum teres of lever where it is attached. So this will be the thing where it will be going to fall. Now let us will go to the back. This where that ligamentum venosum forms earlier to this, such as inferior layer of coronary, inferior layer of right coronary ligament, after running at the posterior and inferior part of that of the right lobe of the lever, it will be going to extend upwards and then it attaches to the under surface of the right dome of the diaphragm. Triangular ligament, after running from the water or after running from the superior layer of the right coronary ligament, it will be going to run upwards in the like pattern. The triangular ligament, after completion, it will be also going to run upwards vertically and gets attached to the water under surface of the right dome of the diaphragm. So these are all such as right from the water, that of the falciform ligament, and the water, that of the right part of the water or a right layer of that of the falciform ligament, left layer of the falciform ligament I will be going to talk. Then there it will be ending the superior layer of the right coronary ligament, right triangular ligament, inferior layer of right coronary ligament. These all will be the what running upwards in the vertical pattern and gets attached to the under surface of the right dome of the diaphragm, where the parietal part of the peritoneum is partially covered. Partially covered. For that, posterior inferior surface of the right lobe of the lever. So that is called as a what bare area of lever. Now we have to go to the water. The left coronary ligament or left part of the water, that of the, you can say, falciform ligament, when it will be going to run on the superior surface of left lobe of the lever, for certain extent it will be going to form the one ligament. Now that ligament is called as left triangular ligament. Left triangular ligament. Now this left triangular ligament is like this. It will be attaching to this the inferior layer of the ligamentum teres of lever. So it is. So this left triangular ligament, after getting formed from the water, that of the left coronary ligament and the left coronary ligament, so that left, this is a left triangular ligament, and you will be having, this is with the yellow, I will be showing with the word dotted, left coronary ligament, continued part of this falciform, attaching to the what under surface of the left dome of the diaphragm after running vertically. So these are also, it is called as vertical disposition of the lateral layer of the peritoneum. So, you have understood what are the ligaments for the lever. You
or the folds of the liver. The folds of the liver are, this is ligamental teres of liver first, then the falciform ligament is the second, right coronary ligament, left coronary ligament. These are the third and fourth and fifth, or third and fourth serially if you are will be lumbering. Then you will be having a what, say, fifth superior coronary ligament, sixth right triangular ligament, seventh inferior layer of the what, coronary ligament. Ligamentum venosum is the what, seventh, and this ligamentum venosum